I'm running, trying to get on this thing, the gate E. I don't know where it is. I'm in terminal B. I need to be in a gate E. And I'm a little bit stressed. We at gate B. And I need to be at gate E 37A, like right now. They already started boarding, so I'm gonna try and make this. I'm not gonna miss this. I'm gonna try really hard and get there. I'm gonna run fast. Just got off the plane now. We're now leaving the airport. As you can tell, I'm in a different setup. I'm actually at my grandparents' house now. Sorry I didn't vlog as much as I wanted to. Some crazy things happened over the course of the last few hours and trying to get to Knoxville. Let's just put it at, it was really hectic and I vlogged when I could, but I didn't have much time to capture as much footage as I wanted to because of the circumstances, but I'll explain that tomorrow. So I'm gonna get some sleep because it's 10:23 and I've been up since 3 a.m. So I've been up over 19 hours now and I'm very, very tired. So good night and I will see you tomorrow when the lighting is better and my brain is fresh. And it's the next day. So I'm not sure where I left off or how much I got to tell you in the midst of the craziness, so I'll just start from the beginning. I'll tell you about what happened in my flight cancellation story. So 11 minutes prior to departure, I get an alert on my phone saying that my flight has been canceled. 11 minutes, really? And this was the third delay, so it was kind of frustrating, to put it at the least. Everyone from our plane went up and immediately started like forming a line for the flight attendants to try and reschedule their flight. I was number 11 in line, so I didn't get there first, but I wasn't last. I ended up waiting for 30 minutes trying to get there and see if I could reschedule my flight because the app told me that I would be rescheduled for tomorrow, which is today, for a whole 24 hours, and I would have to wait at the airport, and that wasn't gonna work since, I mean, I'm only 17, I'm a minor, my parents weren't really gonna be a fan of me doing that. Or my other option was to go at midnight, arrive at Knoxville at midnight, and that was definitely not preferable either. I'd have to make a stop in Miami. So I went up to the flight attendant, and I explained the conditions and how I was only 17, and everything, so she put me on priority for boarding of the next flight to Knoxville. And when she did that, she booked my ticket and everything, she gave it to me. She told me that the plane was already boarding. And guess where I was? Terminal B, 37, and the new gate was E, as in egg, 37A, which is clearly way across the airport. And keep in mind, I've never been to this airport before, Dallas-Fort Worth Airport, so she told me to try and make that flight, and if not, then I'd have to be rescheduled another time. I get the ticket, and I start running. I don't know if I've ever ran that fast in my life, and it was just, from that point on, it was craziness just trying to get there, and that's why I didn't vlog as much. But I'm running across the airport, tripping over my feet, tripping over my luggage, weaving in and out of traffic or the people there and just trying to make it there. So I get on the Skylink and I don't even know if the Skylink is the right one, where it's going to. I just hop on it because I see, oh, D&E, that must be it. I didn't double check or anything because I just didn't have time. So I went on it and it's like, now boarding gates B, blah, 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 or now stopping at gates B. And I was like, oh no, I got on the wrong one. But I didn't. So I just stayed on there for about 5 minutes and then it said, now you can go on go on to E. That's where their next stop was. So it took probably 5-10 minutes to get through the Skylink because they had to make up so many stops. And I'm over here looking at my watch, like freaking out because I'm like, I'm not gonna have time. I'm not gonna make it, because at that point it was like 4:15 and they started boarding at 4:07, which I know only 10 minutes, but still, you want to get there like now. As soon as the doors opened, I ran. I ran down the escalator stairs and started like trying to weave, and then I followed the signs, and it was, like I said, very chaotic. So I make it there, and they're boarding the last group of people on the flight, group 9 out of 9. And I made it there just in time, and there's this old lady in front of me, and she goes, "Are you on standby too?" And I say, "Yeah." And so there was another person on standby, which means that you don't have a seat at the airplane. It just means if they have room, they'll accommodate you. So she was in front of me, and then I'm waiting for 10 minutes goes by. We aren't told anything. And then there's like 6 more people that show up behind me. I don't know how they made it there, because I was like a hot mess. My face was red. I was going panting, trying to get my breath. And they're all just like, yeah, made it here. Like, how? How did you make it here and not like have a mini panic attack while you were going here? Goodness. A few minutes go by, and then she starts accommodating the standby passengers. Then 2 people get called, and then the next time I get called. So I made it on the flight. I go in there and I'm on seat 22D, but guess what? It was not a window seat, so that's why I couldn't vlog the plane taking off and on. I tried to get a little bit of footage, but there's this other old elderly lady sitting next to me, and I didn't want to be too rude because I know that having the camera pointed directly towards the window might look like I was filming her, but I wasn't. So I didn't want to disturb her privacy or anything. So we're on the plane. Oh, this is interesting. We're on the plane, I get situated, sitting by her. Everything's okay, and still waiting, and then the power goes off. Yep. The entire plane's power just cuts off in the middle of right before we're about to start taxiing to go get on the runway. It's all silent, and then the captain makes an announcement. He's like, "Hey guys, sorry about that. We just had a little power outage, so we're gonna have to recheck everything." Lovely. And I'm thinking, I am never gonna get out of Dallas. I'm gonna be stuck here forever. But I wasn't. And finally, after 5 minutes, he gave the all clear, and we started taxiing. Then we got on the runway, and this is it. This is the big moment. And then we lifted off and we made it into the sky, but it was super bumpy because all the thunderstorms were going on, the turbulence and everything. It was very scary. I did some praying. Definitely did some praying. Throughout the whole day, actually. But especially during those moments, they were a little bit not smooth. We're finally in the air and I'm just relaxing, so that was nice. And the rest of the flight was pretty much uneventful. Unremarkable, as those fancy people would say. And then we landed at Knoxville, and I met my grandpa, and he took me out to go to a Mexican restaurant. And I got back, and I talked to my grandparents for a while, which was nice. And then I went to bed because I was really tired, so that's where I left off. That was the in-depth review of all of the things that happened, how I was almost stranded at the Dallas airport. So if you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up and make sure to subscribe to my channel, because you just never know what's gonna happen. If you think that a routine daily flight like mine, first time flying solo at 17, was gonna be uneventful, it was not. So I really hope that you had some enjoyable viewing time while you watched me be stressed and panic throughout the video. But I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.